Yes, children, now let us see question number 4. That is your homework, okay? Question number 4 you have to solve because it's too easy. I will explain you how to solve it and then you have to do it as homework. The question goes like this. A pen stand made of wood is in the shape of a cuboid. Okay, it is in the shape of a cuboid. So cuboid volume we know how to find out. That is L into B into H. Okay, so that measurements are given already. The dimensions of the cuboid are 15 cm by 10 cm by 3.5 cm. That means L is 15 cm, breadth B is 10 cm and height H is 3.5 cm. Okay, so L, B, H, all the three are given. So you can find the volume of the cuboid by multiplying all the three. That is L into B into H. Okay, so volume of the cuboid you will get. After that, what is given? The radius of each of the depression is 0.5 cm and the depth is 1.5 cm. That means what? So you might have seen this particular cuboid is made for what? Pen, holding pen. That means here suppose this is the cuboid, okay, and in this cuboid pen holder shapes are made, okay. So here you might have seen cones like this for keeping the pens it is made, okay. So this one's radius is given as how much? Radius is given as 0.5 cm and the depth is, this depth is how much? 1.4 cm. Okay, so depth means height is given. Cone, it is in the shape of a cone, you can see that. The depression is made in the form of cone. So cone height is given as 1.5. The height of the cone is the depth of the cone. Okay, the depression, that is 1.4 cm. And radius R is given as what? 0.5 cm. Okay. So, volume of the cone, we know that is 1 upon 3 pi R square H. So, volume of one cone we will get, one depression. So, likewise, how many depressions are there? 4. So, you have to multiply 4 times the volume of the cone. Okay. So, now you have to find the area, volume of the solid which is left. Okay, so what it will be? That is volume of cuboid, volume of cuboid minus 4 times volume of cone. Okay, because in this particular cuboid 4 cones are made, 4 depressions of cones are made. So 4 into volume of cone will be subtracting from the volume of the cuboid to get the volume of the remaining solid or the box. Okay, clear, understood? So this question, do it as homework. This is your homework question. Now let us move to question number five. Okay, this question number 4, do it as homework. Now question number 5 is, a vessel is in the form of an inverted cone. Okay, so vessel is in the form of an inverted cone. You can see the figure here. Now, in this what is asked? Its height is 8 cm and radius of its top, which is open, is 5 cm. That means radius is given as 5 cm and height of this one cone is given as 8 cm. Now, it is filled with water to the brim. Brim means this top area. This is called the brim. Brim of the cone. That means up to the last, means top corner also, the water is filled. That is called the brim of the cone. Okay. Now, when lead shots. Shots means it is your circular one. Ball. Short foot. Shots you might have seen. It is an iron ball. Okay. So, that shots are dropped in this vessel. So shots are spherical in shape. Lead shots are spherical in shape. So that means we will take the volume of the sphere okay? So each of which is a sphere of radius 0.5. That means short cylinder shoots are sphere in shape, and whose radius is how much? Radius is given as 0.5 cm. Okay, radius is given as 0.5 cm into the vessel. 1/4 of water falls out. Means how many lead shots are dropped in this? That we have to find. By which the water content now became 1/4 of that came out of the vessel. 1/4 of water came out of the vessel. So how many lead shots will be put in that vessel so that 1/4 of water will be out from the vessel? Okay, that you have to find. Find the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel. Now let us see the solution. Now given that the height of the conical vessel is how? 8. And the radius of the conical vessel is how much? The radius is 5 cm. Then that you can keep it as R1 because R2 is for sphere radius. Okay. So radius R2 of the lead shots equals to 0.5 cm. Okay. Then now let N be the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel, because we are supposed to find how many lead shots are dropped in this vessel. Okay. So let N be the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel. Volume of water spilled. Spilled means thrown out of the vessel. The water which fell out of the vessel, that is volume of water spilled, equals to volume of dropped lead shots. Means how many lead shots we are putting inside that much amount of water will be coming out. So volume of dropped lead shots. Now that is equals to, now here because 1/4 of water is coming out. Is it not? In the question it is specified that 1/4 of water falls out of the vessel. So 1/4 into volume of cone. Okay. Equals to N. N means the number of lead shots. We do not know. We have to find that. Into volume of the sphere. Volume of the sphere formula we know. That is 4/3 pi r2 cubed. Because r2 is the volume of the sphere. So r2 cubed. Okay. So now equals to implies 1/4 into the volume of cone formula we know, that is 1/3 pi r² h. So here r is r1. R is r1 here. So r1 square h equals to n into 4/3 into pi value, and here r2 cube because this is the radius of the sphere and this is the radius of the cone. Okay. Now implies. Now put the values on cancelling this 1/3 here. You can see denominator 3 cancelled off. Here also pi is there. The other side also pi is there. So that is cancelled off. So now this will cross multiply and move there. So it will be here. It will be r1 square h equals to n into this 4 goes there. Means 4 into 4 will be 16. So 16 into r2. Cube. Now implies put the values of each one here. R1 square. R1 is what? 5. So here 5 square into 8. 8 is the height of the cone. H. H is 8 equals to N into 16 into R2 is how much? 0.5 cm. So every time cube is given, so 3 times we'll write 0.5 into 0.5 into 0.5. Now on cancelling you will see that N value we are getting as 100. Okay. So thus 100 lead shots were dropped in the conical vessel. This is the answer. Okay. Now after that let us see the sixth question. Now what is the sixth question? Sixth question is also easy. So you have to solve it as homework. I will explain you what to do. Solid iron pole. Consists of a cylinder of height 220 cm and base diameter 25, which is surmounted by another cylinder of height 16. That means for this figure you will have what? One cylinder likewise, whose height is how much? 220 meter cm or meter cm. Okay, this is cm, and diameter is how much? It is given as diameter of 24. Diameter is given as 24 cm. So radius will be half of it, that is 12. So radius r1 will be how much? 12 cm. Okay, same way another surmounted by another cylinder whose height is how much? Means on this again another cylinder is placed likewise. Okay, this is another cylinder whose height is how much? Whose height is 60 cm and radius is 8. This height is how much? 60 cm, and this radius is how much? Radius r equals to 8 cm. Okay, that means this is r1, so this will be r2. This is h1, this is h2. Okay, so what you have to do? Find the mass of the pole given that 1 centimeter cube of iron has approximately 8 grams of mass. So only thing what you have to do, you have to find the volume of this one, this cylinder, plus volume of this cylinder. Add it, nothing. Just what you have to do, so simple. The volume of the given figure equals to volume of the first cylinder plus volume of the second cylinder. So here R1, H1, volume of the cylinder formula we know. Okay, so put the formulas values and get the volume of the figure. After getting the volume of the figure, it is given that 1 cm cube equals to, it is given in question, 1 cm cube equals to 8 grams. So how many cm cube you will be getting? From there you find how many grams. That will be the answer. Okay, understood? Solve this question as homework. Okay, now after that let us move to the next question, that is question number 7. The question number 7 is, a solid consisting of a right circular cone of height 120 cm and radius 60 cm standing on a hemisphere of radius 60 cm is placed upright in a right circular cylinder full of water such that it touches the bottom. Find the volume of water left in the cylinder if the radius of the cylinder is 60 cm and its height is 180 cm. Now let us see the solution. Now given that one, this is the figure. Inside the figure, this outer part you can see, this is a cylinder whose inside which you have a hemisphere on the bottom, and on the top of the hemisphere we have a cone. Okay, conical part is there. Okay, so now what is given? Given that the radius of the hemispherical part is the radius of the conical part. Now radius of this hemisphere is the radius for the cone also. Radius of the hemisphere is the radius of the cone also. Okay, so which is r equals to how much? 60 cm. Okay, now height of the conical part h1 is given as what? Height of this, it is given as 120 cm. Okay, in the book only, in the question it is given that the height of the conical part h1 is given as 120. Okay, cm. And same way height of the cylinder h2 is given as what? 180. Okay, if this total height is 180, okay, and this part, only half part up to here, if it is 120, then what about this part? Definitely we will subtract from the total height minus this height, so it will be 60. So you got it here, 120 and 60. Clear? Understood? Clear? The radius of the hemisphere, we can get it as 60. Okay? So now radius of the cylinder r is equals to 60, because that is inside this, means whatever will be the radius of the hemisphere, that will be the radius of the cylinder also. Clear? So radius of the cylinder r equals to 60 cm. It is given in the book in question. Now you have to find volume of water left, that is equals to volume of cylinder, that means the whole figure, volume of cylinder minus volume of cone, because inside this we have what? Sphere and cone. So when sphere and cone is placed inside the cylinder, that much amount of water will be coming out, right? So that is why volume of water left will be equals to volume of the cylinder, that means the whole figure, cylinder one's volume, minus the volume of the hemisphere plus volume of the cone. Volume of the cone plus volume of the hemisphere. I think it is clear, because when hemisphere and cone is placed inside the cylinder, automatically that much amount of water will be thrown out, right? So volume of water left will be, that means how much water is left inside the container will be, because this one will occupy some space, means that much amount of water will be out of the vessel, out of the cylinder. So how much is left out is total volume of the cylinder minus volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. Now formulas you put, volume of cylinder formula is pi r square h. Okay, so here volume of the height of the cylinder is h2, so that is why here h2 is written. Minus, now volume of cone formula we know, 1 upon 3 pi r square h. So here h1 plus volume of hemisphere is 2 upon 3 pi r cube. Now put the values of all these values, r1, h1, h2 and r, substitute, and last you will get this as 1, that means 11,31,428.57 cm³. This is in cm³. You have to convert it into meter cube. So what you will do? Just divide it by 10, 1 and 6 zeros in it. Okay, 6 zeros. So 6 digits you bring it forward, 1 decimal values will move forward. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So after 6 value, means before 6 value, put dot. That is why the answer will be 1.131 meter cube. Okay. Now let us move to the 8th question. Now 8th question is, a spherical glass vessel has a cylindrical neck 8 cm long, 2 cm in diameter. The diameter of a spherical part is 8.5 cm. By measuring the amount of water it holds, a child finds its volume to be 345 cm³. Check whether she is right. Taking the above as the inside measurement and pi value, you have to take in this particular question as 3.14. Okay, now let us see the solution for it. This is the shape of the figure. Okay, so down part you can see it is spherical in shape, and on the sphere a cylindrical shape is there. Okay, so now here it is given that height of the cylindrical part is 8 cm, it is given in the question. Radius of the cylindrical part R1 is how much? Total diameter is 2 cm. Diameter of the cylindrical part is 2 cm. Radius will be what? Upon 2. So 2 cm upon 2 will be what? 1 cm. Clear? After that, radius of the spherical part R2 is given as what? 8.5. So diameter is given as 8.5. So radius will be what? Upon 2. So which will be equals to 4.25 cm. Clear? Now, volume of the vessel. This vessel will be what? Volume of the cylinder plus volume of the sphere. The whole figure will be what? Volume of the sphere plus volume of the cylinder. Okay, volume of sphere plus volume of the cylinder. Now put the formulas of each and put the values also. That is, volume of sphere formula we know, that is 4 upon 3 pi r2 cube. Okay, because we have taken the sphere radius as r2. So r2 cube plus the volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. So cylinder's radius is r1. So it is pi r1 square h. Now r1, r2 and h is given. Just put the values and get the answer. The answer will be 346.51 cm3. But the child got the answer as 345. You can see in the book, on solving this, the particular student got, or the child got, the answer as 345, which is incorrect. Because the correct answer is what? 346.51, not for 345. That means the child was wrong. Hence, she is wrong. Understood? Clear, children? To solve these questions in your FAIR mathematics copy, and your homework is question number 4 and 6. These two questions are your homework. Solve it. Okay? I have given you the hint.